convicted of rape.
Yeah, the victim in this case is a 9-month-old infant. Edwin Wren was arrested in October of 2011 after prosecutors say he brutalized the baby girl while babysitting for the child's mother and boyfriend. WESH 2's Claire Metz is live at the Justice Center in Daytona Beach. And Claire, stomach-turning testimony today.
Absolutely, it was, Jim. This baby was traumatically injured. She required reconstructive surgery. However, the defendant claims he was insane at the time of the crime.
It was my opinion that it could have been created by blunt force.
The doctor who operated on the baby girl described injuries that could only have been made by violent intrusion. And prosecutors say this man, Edwin Wren, a family friend, a roommate, attacked the helpless infant.
It was an acute trauma having occurred within hours of her presenting to the emergency room.
Wren was babysitting at the home near New Smyrna Beach while the child's mother and then boyfriend ran an errand. When arrested, Wren denied hurting the baby, claimed to have run out to grab food at this McDonald's, but surveillance shows he was never there. Wren was later found hiding in a Walmart bathroom stall. One of the first investigators to respond to the house immediately saw signs of trouble in the nursery.
What appeared to be small child's clothing, possibly some stains on it that might be blood.
The state introduced a letter Wren wrote to the mother's former boyfriend while Wren was in jail. In it, he admits what happened going into the baby's room, but Wren writes that voices told him to do it. And we've learned the defense is pursuing an insanity case. In the letter, Wren asks the former boyfriend for help.
Please promise me that you will help me out with this, bro. I'm counting on you, bro. I would never do something like that in my right mind. You have to trust me, bro.
Difficult as it all is to hear, the baby's family, she lives with grandparents now, are in the courtroom and will sit through it all. They say they want justice for an innocent. Back live now. The state should finish presenting its case sometime tomorrow, then rest, and then, of course, the defense's turn. It's unclear if the defendant, Edwin Wren, will take the stand. Reporting live in Daytona Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.
In less than half